Coming up on this edition of Rock 11 Now, the mayor and council approved the 2017 fiscal year budget. Find out what that means for you. And Metro is putting its rail repair plan in motion, and the Red Line is part of the work. We'll tell you how you can stay informed. Plus, Hometown Holidays 2016 is in the history books. We relive some of the best moments of Rockville's premier event. All this and much more on the June edition of Rock 11 Now, so let's get into it.
All those in favor of the motion to amend the ordinance as modified in Attachment A, please raise your hand. It is unanimous.
The mayor and council adopt the 2017 fiscal year $126.3 million operating budget. There will be more funding given to the city's five-year plan or the capital improvement plan for funding new construction and infrastructure maintenance. And property taxes will remain the same for the ninth year in a row. However, there will be an increase coming to residential and commercial water, sewer, and stormwater management bills. And there is an increase of $24 per year for recycling and refuse services. Also starting on July 1st, all refuse and recycling charges will appear on the property tax bill. For more information on the change in billing for refuse service, head to rockvillemd.gov/refuse bill. And to learn more about the city's FY17 budget, just head to rockvillemd.gov/budget or call the finance department at 240-314-8400. Looking for a way to get involved in the Rockville community? Then why not apply to become part of the King Farm Task Force? The mayor and council is looking for people to help them identify the best uses for the King Farm farmstead and funding sources to develop the historic property. To apply for the task force, complete and submit the expression of interest form at rockvillemd.gov/boards/commissions or call the city clerk's office at 240-314-8280. And to learn more about the farmstead, head to rockvillemd.gov/King Farm Farmstead. You can connect with the mayor and council at any of their many meetings during the public forum session, or you can email your thoughts and concerns. All the information is right there on your screen. With the recent retirement of Terry Treshick as Chief of Police of the Rockville Police Department, Acting City Manager Craig Seminoe has appointed Major Bob Rappaport as Acting Chief of Police. Major Rappaport has an extensive law enforcement background and is looking forward to taking the lead of the Rockville Police Department.
I'm very honored to have been selected as the Acting Chief of Police. This is a dream come true for me. I've always wanted to, and I'm privileged to lead the men and women of this agency and to serve the citizens of Rockville as their police chief. I've been a police officer since March 1st, 1988. That's over 28 years ago. And I've been blessed to have been worked with some of the finest men and women and learn from those men and women in the law enforcement profession. I've worked with Chief Treshick for 27 of those years, and he's been a great role model and mentor, not only to me, but to the 58 other sworn officers and 33 civilian employees of this agency. And I'm very proud to have said that I've worked with probably one of the truest and greatest professionals.
And the acting chief wants to make sure that the community policing legacy continues under his leadership.
You know, many officers in this agency have either practiced community policing for numerous years, or the bare minimum, they've been practicing it since they've been hired here in the city of Rockville as a Rockville City Police Officer under Chief Treshick. Community policing for our officers is an everyday way of life for them. It's not a philosophical saying. Our Rockville City Police Officers go above and beyond what a typical officer would do in a city of this size anywhere else in the country.
And with several officers on the force nearing retirement, Rappaport wants to make sure that there is always enough officers on the streets to protect and serve.
My first priority is to make sure that we have the best qualified candidate that is representative of the diverse community that we serve. We need to make sure that they're tested, screened, and ready for hire as soon as there's an available position due to a retirement or an opening within the department. My second priority is we need to prepare for succession. Over the past year, we've been doing succession planning to make sure that we have the right people trained and experienced for future advancements and positions and specialized training assignments.
Keeping the department on the cutting edge of new law enforcement technology is also one of his priorities.
We're looking at culminating two big projects. The first project is replacing our decade-old in-car camera system. And our second project is closely related to that, and that is to implement a brand new body worn camera system program for all sworn police officers. They're going to be useful for documenting evidence, for officer training, for preventing and resolving citizen complaints, and also I think it's going to strengthen our transparency, our performance and accountability to the citizens of Rockville.
Major Rappaport will begin as acting chief of police on June 1st. And remember, if you have a non-emergency, you can call the Rockville Police Department at 240-314-8900. And as always, if you have an emergency, please call 911. Metro is fast-tracking its rail repair with its Metro SafeTrack plan. SafeTrack is a plan to improve Metro Rail safety and restore service reliability. The plan accelerates 3 years worth of work into approximately 1 year by expanding maintenance times on weeknights, weekends, and midday hours. Beginning Friday, June 3rd, Metro's system will close every night at midnight to implement the plan. Then on Saturday, June 4th, the work is scheduled to begin on the orange and silver lines. Maintenance on the Red Line, which services Rockville, is scheduled to begin on August 1st and is scheduled to run through November 1st. You can know before you go by signing up for Metro Alerts at WMATA.com/Metro Alerts. And to find out more about Metro SafeTrack, just head to WMATA.com/Metro SafeTrack. Welcome back to Rock 11 Now. Thanks for staying with us. More people are calling Rockville home. According to the Census Bureau's latest population estimates of incorporated cities in Maryland, Rockville gained more people than any other city in the state between July 1st of 2015 and July 1st of 2016. To be exact, the community grew by 1,379 people during that time. Maryland has a total of 157 incorporated cities. Overall, Rockville is fourth among those cities. The Rockville Senior Center puts a spotlight on senior health. The center held its annual free health fair last month that included screenings, testing, and information, among other things, to help promote senior health.
We're bringing in many organizations and county and Rockville resources to the center to distribute and tell the seniors of what we have in the area, which will help them. We have a huge senior citizen population, and we want to see them healthy and keep continuing aging in place.
They've got all kinds of interesting informational stuff. I mean, you know, the police department's getting me set up with this.
The Senior Center provides a variety of information, assistance, and events for Rockville seniors. To check out what the Senior Center has to offer, call 240-314-8800. Once again, Rockville shows its support for National Bike to Work Day.
It's a holiday. No, I like to bike to work if I can, whenever I can, and to have that being recognized is all the more reason for celebration.
I bike to work today. I go to bike to work the way I try to go every year, and I occasionally bike otherwise, so it's a good healthy way to exercise, an alternative to running for me.
It was a chance for bicycle enthusiasts to put those car keys away.
We enjoy it. It's a great event. It's a perfect day for it, you know. Some days it's been raining, but, you know, today's perfect, so I couldn't miss it.
Actually, one of my friends at work decided to do it, and he sent me a link and said, hey, we're all going to do it. I actually had to leave earlier because I live out in Clarksburg, so from Clarksburg all the way to Bethesda.
I live very close by, and I work very close by, so it's perfect for me. It's not such a long, you know, bike ride, and it's still good exercise. So
the city kicked off the day's events in the parking lot of Dawson's Market in Town Square, with breakfast to give you energy, raffles to win prizes, and even giving you options on ways to combine your commute with your bike and the bus.
Where I live, if I live maybe a mile from a bus stop, I could ride my bike, and if I don't want to leave it somewhere safe, I can put it on the bus, and then during the day I have a bike available to me.
Rockville was also honored by the League of American Bicyclists as a bicycle-friendly community at the bronze level.
We've come so far in our ability to allow people to bike, in our what we're offering for people to use to bike, and I'm really proud of Kevin Belanger. He's done a lot of the work himself and really promoted this throughout the city. So today's a beautiful day. It's not raining like it did in the past, and we have a lot of people here celebrating Bike to Work Day.
So mark this year's Bike to Work Day and Bike Month as both huge successes. So why not ride on over to our website to find out more valuable bicycling information at rockvillemd.gov/bicycling.
Hey, did you know that 47% of people in Rockville ride their bikes on a regular basis? Rockville is making sure that kids are getting the opportunity to earn their own bikes.
And in a partnership with the schools and the Rockville Police, RBAC, and our own Kevin Belanger from the city, we put together this course over the winter months and now into the summer that brings these kids together, that teaches them bike skills, bike safety, leadership capabilities, map reading, all those things that are so important for children to know on their own. So it's just a wonderful, wonderful day. For me, it's better than Christmas.
I mean, is this a great opportunity? I met with the mayor earlier in the month, and she told me about this great program that the bike club that she mentioned, and 12 great students. We were able to pull everything together, get 12 brand new bikes with great accessories, making sure they're safe with the helmet, and the celebration here today was outstanding. It was really cool.
It's exciting because when we were thinking about this club, we wanted to be able to bring together positive aspects of the community so that they could interact with our students and they could just have a really great experience knowing who's around and who they can count on in the community, and this was the best culmination of that.
Yeah, I feel great about getting it, and like, these helmets are amazing and everything that people do for us.
From kids earning bikes with hard work to some more Rockville kids earning bikes because they have been terrific.
So the Terrific Bike Program has been around for about 10-15 years. We work with elementary age students, grades 1-5, in order to provide them with bikes that they can earn.
And earning these bikes is a pretty simple task.
They earn the bikes through being a terrific citizen. And being a terrific citizen is trustworthy, earnest, respectful, responsible, involved, fair, industrious, and caring.
Those simple tasks can not only earn kids a bike, but a chance to meet Rockville's mayor and council and be a part of the Memorial Day Parade. The Terrific Bike Citizen Program is an annual program, and Rockville is gearing up for the next group of terrific kids. To find out more about the Terrific Bike Citizen Program, just head to rockvillemd.gov/terrificbikes or call 240-314-8620. And for information about biking in Rockville, head to rockvillemd.gov/transportation and click on bicycling.
Traffic and transportation planner for the city of Rockville. Now that it's warming up, more and more of you are going to be walking outside, which is great. Just be sure to walk inside of a crosswalk when you're crossing the street. Also, make sure to make eye contact with drivers so you can see and be seen.
Welcome back. Rockville is a supporter of the arts, and these next two stories by Rock 11 photojournalists Tony Playa and Hega Balechian show just that. Plus, we follow the winner of the If I Were a Mayor contest on his special day. Check this out.
There'll be a dance studio opening up here, I think in about a month or so. And so Federal Realty approached VizArts and they wanted something to bring an artist in to bring attention to what's happening down here at Rockville Town Square. And so I had a relationship with this artist. I had curated a show of his before. And this is what he does. He travels around the world doing murals of this size and larger. We put the project together within about 2 weeks. And he spent a week here painting and interacting with the public. And it's really been just an amazing, engaging opportunity with the public. Passing by, artists come up to us and ask us questions and all kinds of things. So it's and he's coming back to do a show here at VizArts right across the street next year. So it's a way to really give a lot of promotion to what's happening in this kind of cultural corner on Rockville Town Square. We have fashion shoots just randomly happen. So I think it provides opportunities for a lot of other businesses. But I think as far as quality of life, I mean, just walking down the street, it brightens your day and it's beautiful, you know? Instead of just keeping your head down, going to work, go get your hair cut or whatever, you might take a minute and look around and just enjoy what's around you.
Behind this piece is Earth, actually, very green and blue and brown. Mother Earth is kind of green, blue, brown. The first things that strike out to me when I picture Earth is green and blue.
A lot of my design is based around the black-eyed Susan and the white oak tree, which are both native plants. I think that it's important for a positive change in storm drain runoff. It's a good way to help absorb water is planting plants, so that's what I was going for with my design.
So we're very excited to announce that 6 artists have been chosen to paint their storm drain mural designs onto storm drains in the Twin Brook area. We got a lot of diverse submissions we're really excited about. Some are more abstract, some are more directly related to water quality, but all are going to incorporate the phrase healthy streams start here to help passerbys make the connection between our storm drains and what goes into them and how that affects our local streams, the Potomac River, and eventually the Chesapeake Bay.
I'm an art teacher for MCPS, and this year I based my art curriculum around community art, and I thought, what a better way to show my students that you can be an activist by painting murals in the community.
The storm drain is not just a drain, it's beautiful, it's part of the earth, and what we put in there, we put it in our system. So just an awareness to see the connection to the earth. Yeah.
Yeah, you can contact us directly at environment@rockvillemd.gov. You can give us a call at 240-314-8870, or you can go directly to our website, which is rockvillemd.gov/environment, and we have a whole bunch of different pages on there about how you can get involved as a homeowner, as a business, students, and all kinds of different activities.
Did he show you what a troublemaker he is?
No, I don't believe it.
Believe.
Are you a troublemaker?
Believe.
What's up, Mom?
Bye.
It's an opportunity for them to share their ideas, but the most fun is bringing the winners into Rockville, spending a day with the mayor, riding in the police car, going to lunch, and then the culmination is participating in the mayor and council meeting on Monday night. And some of the best ideas come from the children because they know what works. They know what they want to see in their communities, and this year it's about health and safety, and they know what will work. So.
A unique combination, running in beer. May sound odd, but it's perfect for the inaugural Suds and Souls 5K run on Saturday, June 25th. The Montgomery County Road Runners Club is teaming up with the City of Rockville to present this new 5K. It's a flat, fast course that begins at Town Center and is followed by a post-race party featuring music and beer. And for adult runners, you get a commemorative beer mug. Plus, there's even a kid zone that features activities including a short run for children 10 and under. And while early registration has ended, you can still register the day of the run. Registration is $40 for adults, $25 for anyone between 10 and 20, and $20 for kids under 10. Kids Zone registration is $10 for ages 5 through 10, and kids under 5 are free. For more information, head to rockvillemd.gov/sudsandsouls.
Hey everyone, I'm Rock 11's Willie James Emmon here at the city's premier event, Hometown Holidays. Now there was great food and music from over 30 different artists and bands, but I can't say it all, so my colleague Tony Playa has more in this video recap of Hometown Holidays.
Hometown Holidays is fun.
Hometown Holidays rocks.
The music's great. We're gonna go take a look at the food, so hopefully we can get some good food too.
Okay, yep. So we love food.
We like to eat.
You can have lots of food, lots to drink, enjoy the music, see booths of different vendors, as well as city services. It's all here.
Great opportunity for our residents and our friends to come out and celebrate Rockville and all the things that make us so wonderful.
I like to consider ourselves a bit of a family band.
I love Hometown Holiday because it gives us, Rockville, an opportunity to showcase our city.
I brought my son over earlier today. We were enjoying playing in the sand area. It was great to have the little Rockville bucket and shovel for him.
And as the town center is growing up, it's just become such a fantastic venue. But you got to remember, it's a remembrance holiday and it's a celebration holiday.
We gather today to pay homage to the more than 500,000 heroes who gave their lives in service of their country, and to the more than 83,000 who are still missing in action from World War II and the subsequent conflicts through 2016.
And now that the weather is warming up and summer is here, why not get out and explore Rockville? Rockville has over 30 parks for you and the family to enjoy. There are community centers, a nature center, civic center, and the swim and fitness center, which has an outdoor pool and a newly remodeled indoor pool. Plus, there's camps for the kids and a senior center, too. So why not create, connect, and celebrate Rockville this summer? For more information, head to the Recreation and Parks page on our website at rockvillemd.gov/recreation or call 240-314-8600. Rockville's Farmers Market is open for business.
I like the location. It's convenient. It's not congested, you know, you got a lot of room to roam. He can run around a little bit, you know, and be relatively safe.
I just love it. I love the fresh vegetables. I love the organic farmer. And we're here every Saturday for the season.
The greens are great, tomatoes, the produce, the plants. Everything's great. Fruit is good. It's all good.
It's nice having some of the local restaurants from downtown Rockville. The French place in particular, we haven't been, we've had our eye on, but we haven't been there yet, so it's kind of nice.
What did you get today?
Just got a little juice.
Cheese bread.
A scone, some apples.
We're going to pick up a tomato plant.
So we chose this farmer's market. My son used to go to Richard Montgomery, so we really know the area very well. We're locals. We love it because it's so friendly for people to walk around, have parking. It's close to the cinemas, so you know people do their daily shopping, come in here. And it's just a very friendly and a wonderful. All the people here are just great. So we feel very comfortable in the space.
And why not go green? And bring your own recyclable bag. Plus, you can use your EPT card too. The Farmers Market is open to the public every Saturday until November 19th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Rockville Town Center, the corner of Route 28 and Monroe Street. The National Public Works Week recognized all the public works employees across the country. And in Rockville, people got a chance to see them up close and personal. Plus, get behind the wheel of the city's big trucks at this year's equipment show.
Our staff is quiet as they do their work, and they don't look for big thank yous, but when we get good attendance from the public here where we can show them what we do and why we do it, we're so happy and pleased to be able to share that information with everyone in the community.
We wanted to bring him to show him the actual trucks and give him the experience of seeing them and climbing in them and learning more about what they do, because we read about them in books, but we thought it'd be fun to see them and hear them.
These two kids, they always love the heavy machineries, so this is a great opportunity to see them up close.
And Councilwoman Beryl L. Feinberg even got into the fun and took over the driver's seat of an excavator. Way to get into it, Councilwoman Feinberg. And finally, it's time for Rockville Roll Call. And since it is summer, who best to showcase this month than the people who keep Rockville beautiful? Rockville Green Team, you're on deck.
The Urban Forestry Maintenance Group is the crew supervisor's Rocky Reynolds, who leads a group of very skilled tree climbers. A lot of their tasks are related to street tree maintenance as well as park maintenance. These guys are very skilled. They'll climb to heights of 75 to 100 feet. They'll hang from a rope. They have a chainsaw with them. They do everything from tree pruning to tree removal. It's probably one of the more dangerous jobs that we have within our Parks and Facilities Division. Ball field or athletic field maintenance guys, they're responsible for all the prep that goes into the fields that you might or might have somebody in your family that plays in one of our baseball or softball or soccer or football leagues. They're the folks that line the fields, they regrade them, they add soil, they make sure that they're safe to play on. They do some really specialized turf maintenance above and beyond mowing. They do aeration, overseeding, fertilization. So it's a much higher level of maintenance that you might find that we just do in a general park area, because they are doing very specific work to the athletic fields. They're led by Bill Grund, our crew supervisor, and Jason Bible is the supervisor of that group. Without these guys prepping this field, we would not have the quality programs that we have in our recreation department. As far as the forestry crew, the urban forestry maintenance guys, they are making sure that the trees on the streets are safe, healthy. If we have a dead hazardous tree, we respond very quickly, remove it. They're also looking at the overall urban canopy of the city and making sure that we maintain our status as a Tree City USA, and that's a big part of their job on an everyday basis. Our athletic fields crew get lots of accolades from the RBBA, which is the Rockville Baseball Association, and the RFL, which is the Rockville Football League, which for the high quality and high standards of play that we're able to maintain on the fields. We have 65 parks, we have 30,000 street trees, we have a very green city, we have 40% canopy coverage on our city, and we have numerous recreational programs. And without these two groups, I don't think we'd be able to support those types of programs.
That's going to do it for this month's edition of Rock 11 Now. You can count on us to keep up on Rockville news. And be sure to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, @Rockville11, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Kathy Dantzler, and for the entire Rock 11 Now team, until next time, Rockville.